Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Bobby K. Matthew. I'm an endocrinologist working in Wellcare Hospital, Ernakulam in Kerala. As we know, we are badly hit by the pandemic of COVID and other infections coming. India, China are the world leaders in diabetes. 1 in 5 diabetic patients on earth is either a diabetic or a Chinese person. And Indian statistics show that up to 40% of individuals above 60 years are diabetic or hypertensive. So invariably, the chance of infection getting boomed up in a diabetes is much more higher. And ADA, we know, we look at the optimal glycemic control depending on HbA1c. ADA tells that in new onset diabetes, not at risk of hypoglycemia. Keep your HbA1c tightly controlled less than 6.5. In vast majority of you and me, keep HbA1c less than 7. So in people with a stable HbA1c for months prior, with an HbA1c less than 7, especially on agents not producing hypoglycemia, metformin, glitazone, gliptin, SGLT2, with an HbA1c less than 7, you don't have to frequently monitor blood sugar in this situation. But people with brittle diabetes or changing or fluctuating diabetes, with an HbA1c more than 8, we need to be more cautious and doing an SMBG, keeping our blood sugar between 100 to 180. ADA tells that a fasting blood sugar of 90 to 130 and a peak postprandial less than 180 is always optimal. And in this crisis where people are following stay at home or sitting at home, two things can occur. Some people can go for a good physical activity because they have ample time, good dietary intervention with good split up of meals. Just like ADA tells, 3 major meals with 3 small snacks and optimize their blood sugar with a tighter control. But in other people who are getting depressed, who naked an opportunity to sit at home, eat or drink and have a merry time, they can have a worsening of glycemic status also. So always you should have a cautious thing to keep your blood sugar between 100 to 180. And once this crisis is over, we need to keep our HbA1c checked every 3 months and keep it less than 7. And what are the other things that a diabetic can do to increase the immunity or the protective power against the infection? Physical activity of 30 minutes per day for 5 days per week is optimal. As ACE guidelines and ADA guidelines say, optimal sleep time, minimum sleep hours of 7 hours per day can also boost your immunity by altering your circadian rhythm, and adequate sunlight exposure. We know that a midnight exposure between 11 to 3 o'clock for at least 15 minutes per day can keep your vitamin D in the preferable range of 40 to 60 nanogram per ml. This itself, with an adequate amount of intake of fruits and vegetables which have high amount of vitamin C and antioxidants, can also improve your immune status. And we know this crisis of infection may tide over after 2 to 3 months, but ultimately mortality in diabetes occurs due to 70% of people occurs to coronary artery disease. So we should be more cautious in keeping our HbA1c control, keeping our BP control to the target range advised by ADA, ACE, by BP control of less than 130/80, keeping your LDL less than 70, going for a good physical activity, avoid smoking and alcohol, and keeping your BMI less than 23, and if not that possible, keeping your BMI at least less than 25. So friends, so these are the times that we should get aware of ourselves about our diabetic status, and make our colleagues and invariably the diabetic patients aware that diabetic control with their cardiovascular risk factor reduction is most important for a healthy life. Thank you.